Hello everyone, I'm Maghendra Singh. On behalf of SAG Infotech, would you like to take you through a brief introduction of our software? SAG Infotech designs softwares for CACS and professionals. And today we discuss about the software, which is a Smart Shopee software. Smart Shopee basically an inventory software through which you can maintain your all inventory regarding details, as well as you can maintain your other details. I'll show you that what type of exactly our Smart Shopee work given to you. First, you have to create your company information. So when you click on company information, here you have to mention your basic name of your company and some other details. Other details, like when I click on new option, I show you, just write down what exactly name you want to mention, the PAN details, year if you want to mention, then select your country, okay, and then the state and all basic details regarding for the company what you required. After creating your company, like this one of companies created. Now exit from this one option, and after creating your company, go for the next one option, which is a select company. When you click on select company, first you have to select your financial year and then select your company. Select your company means, because in software you can add n number of companies, so just select the one company on which you want to work right now. For example, I select my SAG Infotech company and then click on OK. So my one of company is created. Look, the name is mentioning here. After this, go for the master. In master, you have to mention the all basic single details regarding for your company. Like if you already have a data, so you can import your data from Excel. Which type of data you can import? You can import your inventory master, you can import your credit detail, your bank details, opening stock and some other details. For example, select your basic details. Here we give you our template. I mean, you cannot directly import your data through any one of Excel. First you have to export our Excel format, which is like this, and then when you fill the details, directly import your select the path, import your sheet and then import your data. So this is the master part. You can add the branches as well, branches or department. If your particular company having some branches or some sections or department, then you can add some branches in master also. After this, next one option, which is the inventory information. Here you have to mention all the details regarding for your inventory, and make sure this is the main important and main part of this one software. For example, I click on new. So here I have to mention your department name, what exactly your department related to the particular inventory. For example, I click on this one tab. So here I can add my particular department name. Like for example, it's a mobile department. So I select one of option, which is a mobile. Then click on OK. So through this way, I can create one of my department. Then I can select the basic department, then same process follow with the category. Click on CA window and then select your category, for I selected already. Then same with your subcategory, I already added all these details, but I show you that these details are mandatory. Like for example, I select mobile as a department, then mention the category that it's Android mobiles, or subcategory that it's related to the particular, like as I say, Apple mobile, then the particular item code that Apple, latest when Apple app, or particular what exactly the code if he having, then color, size, brand and all basic detail. So through this way you can add basic your inventory information, what I already added. When you click on master again, you can do some other works. Like there is a option item packet label, you can add the details that what exactly the item quantity or unit your particular inventory having. Then add your default rate, if some default rate you want to mention. Then what exactly the AMC master, AMC that what exactly on date or AMC name, or what exactly the particular detail of your inventory. Then some other details like group master. Now there is an option creditor or debtor, your seller or purchaser. So if they belong to a particular group, so just click on the master and add your basic group. For example, I select one city, Bhopal. So what exactly the sellers or purchaser belong to this one city, I can add these as a creditor master or debtor master. Just select this one option, Mention the name, group and all basic details and create your this one sheet. When you completely create your master, scroll it down. Here we give you the employee master also, where you have to mention your all basic details regarding that what exactly the name he having, code they having, designation, departments and all. Or when you click on master again, you can add a discount offer. I mean, if someone discount offer going on particular inventory or particular, you know, the particular thing what you mention in a inventory, you can set a particular discount offer as well. So this is exactly completely your masterwork. Then there is a opening option where you enter the opening stock entry for your creditors or debtors. One of main part is also there, which is a manufacturing. Manufacturing is not belong to this one software, but it's just a different software. Because if you know you maintain some inventory and same time you also develop or you know manufacturing the particular thing on your place as well, then you have to add all basic details regarding for your manufacturing. Like if you creating one, what I say, bottles. Okay, for example, I have inventory which is a bottle. So if they you also manufacturing your plastic bottles in your particular company and all, and so add your basic all related detail for your manufacturing as well. Click on new, mention your particular master, group name or material detail. If they have a raw material, packing material, process material, I mean the basic master detail for the manufacturing purpose, what you required for manufacturing something. Then if they have some separate charges, I mean if you purchase some raw material, so what's the name of your particular seller or purchasers, then you have to add, or you can directly give purchase something, then directly generate the bill for your seller purchaser. But I already told you it's a different part related with your previous window. What I told you, it's a separate window for all things are separated. That's why I told you that purchase sale bills or everything are separated from the previous one window. Then there is a manufacturing process, that what exactly the process you follow. If some job card, job status related for your particular employees for this one manufacturing unit, or report, that what type of reports you got. Like you can generate your job status report, job history that your employer joining at that time or resign at that time. Some issue registers, that if some issues are belonging that on this one day you have a this one type of issue, you can add these one sheets as well. Then your purchase register, your sale register, all basic details. These details are related to the manufacturing only. When you exit from this one, details or details are only on manufacturer part, not in this one report. I mean, if you thought that I mention or add some things in this one manufacturing part, and when I got in this one report, I easily got the all details. But all manufacturing details or reports are related on this one report part, not with the previous this one window. So this is exactly a manufacturing part. If you're doing manufacturing work, then you can use this one option as also. After this, we give you some other one option, which is a purchase. So now if you want to generate the particular bill or something, then first you have to make a purchase order if you follow the all process exactly. So just mention the name, your voucher number, your date, your supplier name, and then if you take out a particular print, then there is a no bill format right now because I have not generated any bill. So you directly generate a purchase order. Okay, right now it's showing a message also, it's a pending. Then after making a purchase order, you go for the purchase against PO. Then same process you have to follow. Click on new option, mention your bill number if you have some bill number, or you set some bill. Okay, then supplier name, I already mentioned in party name. Then other details like inventory information or PO number is not selected right now. Then through this way you can prepare the sheet, or there is an option save. You save the detail, view your bill and all. So this is all about your particular purchased against PO. And if you want to directly generate a bill, that you purchase something and directly generate a bill, then click on purchase, click on new. When you click on new, details are automatically there. directly take out, or if you want to view the details. So this type of details will be generated. I'll show you in a report. I'll show you later the bill format. So this is exactly the detail that you directly fill the particular purchase information form and take out a bill. This is related with your purchase thing. Purchase return is also there as per the bill wise or as per the supplier wise as well. Then sale option is also there. When you click on sale, what exactly you got? You got all basic details. That there is some option, you know, approval, then approval return, then direct sale option is also there. As I already showed you, that first you have to select the department, let us select computer, and then I click on OK. So window will be appear where I have to mention that if some table, group or something is follow, I click on cancel. Now I generate the basic details. Okay, I just fill the details. Table group, if some table group is there, so I just mention two. I think hide this column. Okay. So this is a part for your generating direct sale. You add your particular voucher number, date, select your party name, show item wise detail, and then generate your particular sale manager. Then when you click on sale again, some other details are also there, like your AMC manager detail, the sale return detail, or if you want to generate C form entry, then you can generate your C form entry as well. So this is exactly sale purchase regarding. Now there is the option services. In service master, you can add or prepare a master of your services, that it's a monthly, quarterly, annually, and all. What if the charges follow on your particular services? So you can manage your service reports or sheets as well. Just mention your service name, on under which one group it's come to, and what exactly effective date. If some description if you want to mention, and then select that it's a monthly, quarterly, or annually, all other. And then just set a particular charge if some charges are there. Like I select the computer and then I click on save. So I generate a particular report also for the services. And regarding for this one services, there's a customer service mapping is also there, that on which one client or party I give this one services, I set a entry also. Then you can generate a service bills or receipts. When you click on services bill, first you have to add your service master in master option, then you generate your bill or receipt for the services what you provided to your particular clients. So this is all about these things. Now just go for the next option, which is the data stock transfer import. You can import your data from what department to department or branch to branch. Then there is option room booking. Look, if you know, this one software is an inventory software, but if you have a restaurant or hotel something, that inventory is also a part of these places, and as well as the inventory, you also required some. Look, if you have a hotel or restaurant, then room booking details are also there. Then that time you generate some bills or something, bills regarding for the services what you given to them. So for this one thing, we give you this one option as well. What you have to do, first you create your room master detail, that if some, you know, categories are related to your room, that it's a luxurious rooms, or what is the facility you given through this room, total number of rooms. This type of master you have to create one time. Okay. And when you create your particular master, then you make a details that booking regarding that the what exactly status currently, it's a booked or pending or alone, or it's a free for given to anyone. Look, here we give you vacant, check-in, no status, client. So you can use this one software. Look, this is not possible to show you these detail in a demo particular, but yes, when you take an installation, we show you that what exactly the features we give you in this one option. Right now I just show you that yes, these are the features of our software. So friend is also part of this. I mean, someone generate an inquiry, some complaint if they raised, or some sale order. So you can maintain these type of friend disk things also with the software Smart Shopping. Then when you're doing all this thing, report is a basically important part of. So there is the option report. through which you can generate the basic report. Like when I click on stock, you can generate your stock transfer register. You select your basic register, okay, for example related with the stock registers or stock receipt. Click this one option, and then there is option through which you can take out a print, like print report, export to Excel. I mean, you can, you know, export this one report in Excel format, show or hide detail if you want to, some details showed or hide, or filter option. So your all basically shortcut keys we also given that time. Same time we give you your inventory registers also. Like if I, you know, generate one purchase order, so I click on purchase register, so I got a detail that on that day I purchased this one thing and through this one department, so I generate a report of this one things as well. Same, I generate some other reports like creditors or debtor report. Okay, I have some credit debtors, so if I have some, you know, particular closing balance for them, payment register or due registers also for the particular your creditors or debtors. So this is a part of your this one thing, and some approval also, your same with your sale registers also. So this is all related with your report. Then here we give you some other report also for your tax report, service wise tax detail or percentage wise, company report, that what exactly dues related with your creditors or debtors, or other reports like reorder report or your user logger report. When you click on user logger, here we give you a sheet that you can set a particular user, that this is my administrator, okay, what exact time he log in or he log out, or all these basic details. I easily know that these sheets as well. In reports, we give you after this there is one more option, which is the export to tally. You can export your ledgers or mapping your ledgers through our software to tally. Then there is the option utility. When you click on utility, we give you a facility, a barcode reading. By using this barcode, first you have to set your barcode setting, okay, and then you easily generate or, you know, set a barcode with the software. This is exactly a part of utility. Same barcode printing option is also there. You easily take out a barcode print with the software. And then there is a option which is a tax manager. You can maintain or manage your particular tax related with your particular inventory. So all exactly it's a round off or decimals or upper lower. Through this way, or what is the effective date, through this way you can maintain your particular tax manager. Then user panel, this is one of an important part of our software. Through this you can set a particular login IDs as a user or as an admin. Okay, click on new, then just mention a user rights. User right means, look, there is an option assign rights. Through this option, what you can do, you can assign the particular rights to your option, that they can only even to, you know, open the sale options, or only for the purchase option, or they can manage only the reports. So through this way you can set a rights for the particular users. So this is a part of user panel. Then option settings also there, where you set a particular options or format setting. For example, this is exactly a format related with your bill. I show you that what type of bills we give you. I just click on exit. So half bill page or full bill. Then select default, and then click on print preview. So this type of particular bill I can easily generate with my software. And if you you know, require some other type of details, like I already told you that we can, you know, give you the barcode facility, and then your AMC bills, so you can easily take out your AMC bills also with the software, or some other bills related with like your room booking or your room billing or room services. So this is all related with your particular bill format. Then you can set a themes. Right now here we give you 2 to 3 type of themes. If I required this one ocean blue color, so I can click on next and select this one theme. Same with your online connection. I already told you room booking status, that what exactly hotel billing, service billing or receipt billing you required, you set your basic details, and we also give you the support regarding for these using facility, that how to use exactly. Then take a backup of your complete software if you want to format, or you know, want to switch to software from this computer to other. Restore facility, show the reminders, like you know, some of bills or you know, reports are pending, then you can set a reminder. It automatically reminds you like this. Right now it show you that one of my Mac party having a bill amount, this is due amount, last date is this, so I easily got a reminder. With the utility, there is a key manual is also there, which is a main part, okay, through which you easily got the shortcut keys. Like if you want to insert some detail, then there is option open entry, click on insert option, or you know, export Excel, setup or report, all shortcut keys are also there. Then this is a check printing option. Here we give check printing options also, and in others we give you the converter or miscalculator normal, a miscellaneous option here where you can, you know, search your basic details like STD code, PIN code, validate your PAN or TAN and etc. So this is all about our software, which is a smart Shopee software. If you want to know more about these details, please call us or take an installation. And for calling, please call us our number, which is 0141-4072-000, or you can also send us a mail on info@saginfotech.com. So that's all about our smart Shopee software. Have a nice day. Thank you.